Good morning, friends. Let's have a pre-market check on the global commentary market. First, the US markets yesterday closed almost flattish, 3 points down Dow Jones. Not much movement was seen yesterday as well. Almost all the data have been kind of priced in the world markets. It's been like a Thursday and Friday, all the data do come out, so there was not much excitement as well. Coming back to the Asian indices, like Nikkei is in the green, well as Hang Seng is a bit flat to negative. SGX Singapore Nifty is down by 6 points, so nothing kind of great that way as well. It's been a pretty lackluster trade so far. We saw kind of in the world markets. Only the Indian market that has been outperforming conditionally on every occasion. Yesterday too, we saw FI buying to the tune of 600 crores. On the other end, DI were the sellers to the tune of almost 300 to 400 crores. So we are seeing kind of continuously buying by the FIIs, keeping a lot of hopes on the new government that a lot of reforms will be passed. Friends, that's all from the global commentary market update. Now I'll forward it to Sadhana for the derivatives checkup.
Good morning, friends. Let's have a view on derivatives. Yesterday, once again, Nifty showed an extraordinary performance in yesterday's trade. As we have seen, the Nifty started the session on a negative note, but later it showed a resilience on lower levels, and from there it turned into a positive territory, and also broken a straddle break-even point of 7814 and made a new lifetime high at around 7839 odd levels. And Nifty finally snapped the session with a significant gain of 0.54%. In this period, we have seen that open interest also increased by approximately 0.72% from 1 crore 97 lakhs to 1 crore 99 lakhs, as around 1,43 lakh shares were added in open interest, and price also increased by approximately 42 rupees, which is clearly indicating that long positions were built up in yesterday's trade. Also, cost of carry increased by 185% from minus 2.46, it increased to 2.10%. And Nifty futures premium also turned into a premium from 3.10 paisa from a discount of 4.20 paisa. On the options front, PCR is increased by 2% from 95 to 97, which is clearly indicating that put option has added good number of shares in yesterday's trade. Yesterday, around 18 lakh shares were added in put option, whereas call option has added around 5 lakh shares in open interest. India VIX increased by 0.20%, 0.20% from 14.69 to 14.72. In the call options activity, we have seen that 7,700 call option has seen reduction in open interest, whereas 7,800, 7,900 has seen good activity. And on a put option, we have seen that good amount of writing was seen in 7,700, 7,800 and 7,900 call option. As in yesterday's trade, 7,900 was active put option in yesterday's trade. And as of now, 7,800 stands with highest number of shares in open interest. There are 5 securities in bank period today. One is GMR Infra, second is HDL, third is Indiabulls Real Estate, fourth is JP Associate, and fifth is Unitec. Yesterday, FIIs were net sellers of 118 odd crores in future and option segment. They were net sellers of 81 crore in index futures. They were net sellers of 199 crore in index options. They were net buyers of 180 crore in stock futures, and they were net sellers of 17 crore in stock options. Our 5-day CBM stands at 7762. Lower edge for the market would be 7700. And as yesterday, Nifty has broken our straddle break-even point of 7814. So we may see Nifty can move towards up to 7900-8000 levels. Singapore Nifty is down today by 5 points, which is at 7825. We may see marginal flattish to negative step in Nifty futures today. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Hello friends, welcome back to the pre-market action update. We'll start with the actionable ideas and the watch list and then the news and updates. We'll start with the actionable ideas, the long one, Ranbaxy. CMP 562 signed a license agreement with Cipher Pharma to exclusively kind of market and distribute the estradiolone capsules in Brazil markets. Till now it has been kind of used in treat severe acne and distributed in US markets by Ranbaxy. Now Brazil is the new country and the new market, which should open up new revenue possibilities for the Ranbaxy. Action long Ranbaxy, stop loss 550. Target on the upside we have 589. Next long idea we have is JP Associates. CMP 62. Two domestic majors, the Adani Group and JSW, have emerged to buy the potential bidder for power plants owned by JP Group. Now, this was like kind the groups are likely to gather momentum at the Abu Dhabi National Energy, which almost bid to 10,500 crores. JP Group is kind of reeling under a big debt burden of almost to the tune of 55,000 crores. They are kind of slowly rid of all the assets which can generate cash and pay off their debts. Actual long JP, stop loss 60 half, target 65 on the upside. Stocks with positive bias, on the watch list we have Glenmark, Biocon, SKS Microfinance. With negative bias we have Voltas, IOC and Gale. These are for the intraday basis. Results to watch out: PNB, first quarter estimated 11.0 billion rupees. Then we have Ashok Leyland, estimated negative 799 million rupees. LIC Housing Finance estimated 3.58. We have Colgate, estimated 1.39 billion rupees. Then we have Allahabad Bank as well as Indian Bank in the banking space today. On the news and updates, the CCEA, that is a sign-off and proposal to raise the FDI and insurance limit to 49 from 26. Now, when approved, the diabetic, the government kind of procured food grains to be off. So, this is definitely a big boost for the kind of sector as well. Next is Tata Steel raised $1.5 billion. Now, this is about 9,000 crores in a dual tranche bond sale. They have been very successful in raising this kind of bond sale money. And this is again, the bond money was raised by the Singapore arm of Tata Steel, and they are again showing faith in the company. Issue got an oversubscribed worth almost $9 billion according to the merchant banking sources. So, there's been a good response seen. Telecom major Bharti Airtel banked a third 3G license in Nigeria. Now extends a 3G footprint to 17 African countries, which will allow Airtel to launch services in those areas such as mobile internet, video telephony. This is almost like being one of the largest subscribers there out there. JSW Energy is close to acquiring Lenco Infra's 1200 megawatt Woody Beast power plant in a deal worth nearly 6,000 crores. Now this is again Lenco's bid to kind of also reduce its debt burden, like JP Associates. The acquisition would help the Sajjal Jindal-led firm in realizing an ambitious kind of energy-led, having 11,770 megawatt power generation capacity. From currently it has 3140 megawatt at present. So this will definitely benefit JSW Energy as well in the long run. Thank you friends for this follow-up from our side. Have a good trading session.